Good morning, student. In this part, we are going to learn the traditions of historiography. In the previous part, we learned the different types of the researches, and what type of methods have been used by the researchers to prove the historical documents or historical monuments or the events or dates. Or the chronology or sequences. So here in the next part, here in this part, we are going to see the traditions of history. We have learned about the historical research methods in the previous period. We have learned about the historical methods and researches. Critically examine, analyzing narratives, writings of critical historical narratives is known as historiography. Dear student, two more questions will be asked to you. What is meant by historiography? So, your answer is that critical examination, analysis of historical documents or script or etc. That is called the narrative of that critical examination and analysis. That narrative is called historiography. A scholar who writes such narrative is a historian. The next question can be asked to you that who is called historian? The answer of that question is, whatever the documents, monuments, scripts, lipids, writings, etc., that all these things are critically examined, analysis, and cross-checked with the historical events and places and dates. And after that cross-check, after that examination, after critical analysis, a person who is narrating all that things, that person, that scholar who is narrating all that things, that narrator or that scholar or that person is called historian. So this type of answer you have to write down in the examination. The historian cannot include every past incident. It is impossible for him. He cannot narrate all that things which were happened in the past. It is very much impossible for him. Historical events by the historian often depends on the chronological conceptual homework. He just imagine, because it is very much tough task for himself to link all the past event and put forth to you. It is too much difficult for him. That's why what he done, he linked that all past things in a chronology and the summary of the important events or a very important dates he mentioned in his writings or in his narration. That is his homework, the conceptual imagination or some homework done by him, and that is homework or that conceptions put forth by him to you. Next one, his style of writing determined that conceptual homework. His style of writing, the main or the important point is that his style of writing is very much important, in which style he is writing all the narrations. The narration of writing historical narratives, that is historiography, was not prevalent in the ancient societies of the world. All these documents we will not found exactly up to date in the societies or in the libraries. That does not mean that they were not aware of the historical time or were not eager to know about the ancient people, also felt that need of passing on the stories of the life and generation. Ancient communities all over the world used the various means like caves, paintings, storytelling, singing songs, folk arts, some lipis and some scripts, some documents, some stones, some events by the passers. All these things were included in his writing. Means he's not just examining, or he's not just looking, or taking one thing for his narration. He included all these things in his narration. Storytelling, some he visited to the people who were living, who were belong to that generation, and then he start writing or narration his stories or narration his story. So students, in this chapter we are going to learn about what type of methods to create the history or to write the history, to write the histories. Histories means the past event, and it is very much difficult to us to narrate that past event. The past events are not exactly true or correct, but somehow it is correct. Somehow it does all are true or very much proved. Dear students, here we just know the concept of writing history, how the history come to us and what is the homework behind to that history. Any event or anything from the history, if you are going to learn, there are too much hard work behind that history. The historians took great effort to write down the history. If they want to write anything from the past, they took all the evidences related to that things, to that event, to that incident. They visited to that people from that generation. They interview some storytellers. They examine some scripts, examine some stones, caves, paintings related to that period, and then they put forth their story. That story is called history, what we are learning today. So this is the tradition of historiography. Here we stop. We will see in the next grade.